What, her word against an officer's? At least in here, she'd be free from that sort of a threat. Wouldn't you say so, Vera? Oh, they might get proof one day when one of the inmates hangs herself because she can't stand the abuse any longer. Now, if you want to send her back to that sort of a threat, then you're the one that's going to have to live with it.
I had no idea.
Well, you never do.
It still doesn't alter the fact that the women hero worship her, and that's dangerous.
Well, I don't see how. If it make you feel any better, I'll ask her to keep away from them as much as possible. All right?
If any of the women take advantage of your past relationship with Nolan, I won't hesitate to write another report.
I've been thinking about what you said to me, Mrs. Davidson, and, well, Lizzie and me would both like to try studying.
Yeah, and then we'd be able to do what Karen Travers did and go out on study release. Of course, we know we're not ready for the university yet. We'd have to start with the easy stuff first. But I'm as bright as a button when I set me mind to it. Of course, Dor might have a bit of trouble, but I could always help her out.
Lizzie, don't you think we ought to take this one step at a time? All classes will have to be done by correspondence until you reach a certain standard. Doreen, can you remember what level you'd reached when you left school?
I think I was about 12.
Oh, I was out working by then. Of course, in those days, that would have been a really good education.
Lizzie, don't you feel you might be attempting too much? It's not easy to return to study after all these years.
Well, just because I'm getting on a bit doesn't mean that I wouldn't want to try something new. I mean, I'd like to brush up on my English. I'm going to write my memoirs one of these days. I want to be famous like Jackie.
May I ask what started this sudden interest in education?
Oh, well, we were talking to Jackie, and me and Lizzie reckon that we might go into business when we get out.
That's if she can make her mind up what?
Oh, we know we've got a long way to go, Mrs. Davidson, but we figure that we might get time off for good behaviour, and if we can show the parole board that we're trying to improve ourselves, you know, I mean, you don't get such a hard time if people think you've got a bit of class.
And what exactly do you mean by class?
Well, you know, if we were a bit more like Jackie, you know, and had done okay on the outside and spoke real good and had important friends, well, we might not have ended up in here.
Jackie Nolan did?
Yeah, but for how long?
Oh, come on, Jackie, you're the only one in here who speaks real good. You gotta help us.
Yeah, we can't very well ask Dave or one of the screws.
I don't know anything about giving speech lessons.
You can give it a go. We just want a few pointers, you know?
All right.
You don't know what you're letting yourself in for.
Well, let's see. I think the main problem's with your vowels.
Nothing wrong with mine.
Vowels, Lizzie. Well, Doreen, you first. Say after me. A-E-I-O-U.
A-E-I-O-U.
Not bad. Now you try, Lizzie.
A-E... No. I-O-U. Do you? How much? Got you there, didn't I, Dor?
I didn't hear the bell. Or are you wasting time playing the fool?
Jackie's just teaching us to talk proper, Miss Bennett. Hasn't stopped us from working.
Does it make you feel important having these women look up to you, Nolan? You know, you surprise me, Smith. I didn't think you'd be taken in like the others. Haven't you realized it yet? The only difference between Nolan and the rest of you is that she happens to know the right people. It's not what you know, it's who you know.
Must be tough when you haven't got either. Hey, Vera?
Why do you think she's so special? Because she made a laughingstock out of the prison system.
Now, that wouldn't be hard.
My guess is it's because she wasn't caught for 6 years. And when you tried it, you were back inside within a few days. The one thing you all seem to have forgotten is she's still a criminal. Just as much as the rest of you. You all have to serve time as punishment. Why shouldn't Nolan? She's supposed to serve another 3 years. Do you think that's fair, Smith? Knowing you have to stay inside because you don't have the necessary influence to get you off. If you do, then you're more stupid than I thought. Now get back to work. All of you.
bloody stupid door. Who's going to be talking to a flaming cow?
Yeah, and what if it answered back?
I'm doing mooncake.
Hey, B, why don't you ask Davo if he can take voice lessons with us?
Oh, sure. I'll go top of the class of H block.
But you've got a plan for your future.
I have. 10 more years in this hole. Look, the only thing I was ever good at was being a housewife, and I blew that.
Listen, you did hairdressing.
And who's going to take on a 50-year-old trainee? That's what I'd be, you know, to catch up on all the new styles.
You can come into business with us.
Look, I'm not a Jackie Nolan. I never was, and I never will be. I'm not ashamed of what I am, either. Any person worth half their salt would accept you for what you were and not be conned by phony dressings.
I don't reckon it's fair.
No. I wish they'd let her out while she's still young.
Yeah, I wish we knew some important people. Maybe we do. Come on, Dor. G'day, love. What you doing?
Julian brought me some homework to catch up on.
Oh, how'd he manage that?
Mr. Fletcher... There's nothing wrong with me keeping an eye on the business while I'm in here, is there?
Of course not. Especially as you're going to get out soon.
Yeah, it looks that way.
You're real lucky to have mates who'll stick by you. Important ones, too.
Not like Bea. She was a great success on the outside. She was the best hairdresser around. She had shops all over town.
She used to look after the ladies, none of your common riffraff.
Really? I didn't know that.
Of course, that's going back some time. They were all snobs in them days, and that's why they never stuck by her.
But I bet they would now if she had someone pulling for her.
Yeah. Good idea, Dor. Maybe you could speak to your mate.
What do you mean?
Well, if anyone deserves to be pardoned, Bea does.
Look, I can't. It's impossible. It's got nothing to do with Bea. Well, don't you see? I mean, she's in for murder.
She had a darn good reason.
Doesn't matter what you did, you still got time. So if you get off, why can't you put in a good word for Bea?
There's a big difference between myself and Bea Smith.
What are you two doing in here?
Just having a bit of a chat, Mr. Fletcher.
Yeah, well, I want a word with Nolan. Go on.
Mr. Fletcher, seeing as how you let Jackie bring some stuff in, I was wondering if you'd let me bring some stuff in from home. You know, just a couple of comfy chairs, make the cell a bit more homey, you know?
And a decent bed.
There's a big difference between a couple of magazines and some furniture, so don't talk nonsense now. Would you two get out of here?
No. Oh, strikes me there's a lot of difference about a lot of things around here.
The receptionist told you we don't allow reporters in here.
Well, I thought if I could get past the gate, maybe I could persuade a charming woman like yourself to give a bloke an even break.
Do I have to call other officers and have you thrown out?
Oh, come on, lady, you can't turn down the Verity. It's the best paper in town.
I know what sort of a newspaper it is.
Look, all I'm after is a bit of info on Nolan. Well, do you think she should be let off?
Of course you should. Desmond.
I'm with the prison reform group. Now, if you ask me, I think
Mrs. Davidson's waiting to see you. I suggest you speak to her first. Now, Officer Barfield, could you show this gentleman out, please?
I'll stick around outside.
You've got no right to speak to the press.
I'm not one of your inmates now, Vera.
While you're in here, you'll do as I say.
You just don't like seeing justice being done, do you?
Justice is what put Nolan in here in the first place.
Coming up with good ideas, B. What business do you reckon we ought to go into?
Well, how the hell should I know? That's up to you.
It would be better if you'd come in with us. And the parole board would like it too, if you had someone to come out to.
Listen, why don't you just leave a person in peace and go off and practice your vows?
How can you try to improve yourself if you're always being treated like dirt?
Yes, well, if you want to be like Jackie, you're going to have to keep working at it.
Maybe she thinks that she's better than us too.
Mm. All right, what's happened?
Oh, nothing. We were just thinking that if you twisted Jackie's arm just a little bit, she might be able to do something for you.
What?